All right, guys, we are going to talk about some built-in functions before we move on, and then we're going to get on to defining our own functions and the different parts of a function. So let's go ahead and open up a terminal here. I want you guys to loosely follow what I'm doing here so that you guys can get used to using these functions, which I think we're going to be using some of them quite a bit, and you're going to be using some of them quite a bit once you're done this course. So these are some basic, very basic functions that we need to learn about. We're not going to go through any modules like the math module or anything like that. We're just going to go through a few basic functions. So let's jump into a Python console here. And we've already learned about a few, so they're just going to get a quick mention here. You can print out on the screen in the terminal whatever you want to, basically using the print command. You can convert things to a string using the str function. And you can do this for both integers and floating points, and actually booleans. You can convert that to string. And then for each of these types, you can also convert them to their own types if they are a string. So I can use int here, and it's going to convert that to an integer. I could use int that, and oh, sorry, float. I can use float to convert 5.6 to an actual number, and then you can perform mathematical operations on it if you want. Now, let's say we have a string like true, and we want to convert that to a boolean to actually be able to test things with it. What we do is type bool, and there we go. That's going to convert that to a boolean operator. Now, let's also talk about a command called len. Basically, what this is it's going to determine the length of something. So it can work with arrays and strings. So let's go ahead and try and figure out how long hello is, which means how many characters are in this, and there are five. Now, this command can also be used on an array. So one, two, just a few random numbers in there. And it's 5 digits long. Now, also, if you were to put strings in here, each with different number of characters, you would see that this is still going to be equal to the number of items and not the number of characters within each item. So that's how to calculate the length of an array. Now, another thing you can do with an array that's pretty neat is sort the array. So let's go ahead and create an array, which is, let's say, we're going to put some random numbers in here in, no specific order. There. Now, as you can see, this is incredibly random, but let's say that we wanted to sort the array into lowest to highest, or first to last. What we would do is actually wrap it in a function called sorted, and this will shift around the array until all numbers are in ascending order. Now let's do the same with an array with strings instead. So let's create some letters here. Couple issues with that line of code there. So it sorts it. But as you'll notice, the A is at the end. Well, why did that happen? If we were to capitalize it, they would be at the beginning. So again, if we turn some of these letters into lowercase, which obviously come before other letters here, and one more. you can kind of see how it's working. The capital letters are parsed first because that's just the way it works, and then lowercase number letters. And what if we threw a number in there? You'll see that it can't do that. So what you would have to do is wrap it in quotes. And let's throw another number right here. And a floating point wrapped in quotations. And you're going to see that the way this sorted is it put numbers first, regardless of if it's a floating point or integer type. They have to be wrapped in quotations in order to be sorted with other strings in an array. And then it parses the capital alphabet and then the lowercase alphabet. So that's kind of a priority order there. So just so you guys are aware of that. So what we're going to do next is actually explore functions. This was just a few basic built-in commands in Python that we are going to use through the rest of the course. And we're probably going to, well, we definitely are going to find other built-in functions as we move along as we need them. So let's get into functions.